whole eternity, one God, the keeper of the covenant, the source of steadfast love, our rock and our redeemer. God hears us when we cry and draws us close in Jesus Christ. Let us return to the one who is full of compassion. Fountain of living water, pour out your mercy upon us. Our sin is heavy and we long to be free. Rebuild what we have ruined and mend what we have torn. Wash us in your cleansing blood. Make us alive in the spirit to follow in the way of Jesus as healers and restorers of the world you so love. Amen. Beloved, God's word never fails. The promise rests on grace. By the saving love of Jesus Christ, the wisdom and power of God, your sins are forgiven. And remember, and God remembers them no more. Journey in the way of Jesus. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, you make nothing you have made, and you forgive the sins of all who are bound. Create us new and honest hearts, so that truly repenting of our sins, we may receive from you the God of mercy, full pardon and forgiveness,
through your Son, Jesus Christ,
our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
Please be seated. Because of the coming day of the Lord, the prophet Joel calls the people to a community lament. And the repentant community declares that God is so gracious and asks God to spare the people, lest the nations doubt God's power to save. It's a reading from the second chapter of the prophet Joel. Blow the trumpet in Zion. Sound the alarm on my holy mountain. Let all the inhabitants of the land tremble, for the day of the Lord is coming. It is near. A day of darkness and gloom, a day of clouds and thick darkness. Like blackness spread upon the mountains, a great and powerful army comes. There like has never been from old, nor will ever come again after them in the ages to come. Yet even now, says the Lord, return to me with all your heart, with fasting and weeping and with mourning. Rend your hearts and not your clothing. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love, and relents from punishing. Who knows whether he will not turn and relent and leave a blessing behind him, a grain offering and a drink offering to the Lord your God? Blow the trumpet in Zion. Sanctify a fast. Call a solemn assembly. Gather the people. Sanctify the congregation. Assemble the aged. Gather the children, even infants at the breast. Let the bridegroom leave his room and the bride her canopy. Between the vestibule and the altar, let the priests and ministers of the Lord weep. Let them say, spare your people, O Lord, and do not make your heritage a mockery, a byword among the nations. Why should it be said among the peoples, where is their God? Here ends the reading from the prophet Joel. Our psalm this afternoon is Psalm 51. You'll find it on page 239 of the Lutheran Book of Worship, verses 1 through 18. We'll read the psalm responsibly by alternating verse. Have mercy on me, O God, according to your loving kindness. In your great compassion, blot out my offenses.
For I wash you through and through from my holiness, and cleanse my from my sin.
For I know my transgressions, and my sin is ever before me.
Against you only have I sinned, and done my vehicle in your sight.
And so you are justified when you speak, and upright in your judgments.
Indeed, I have been wicked from my birth, from my mother's womb.
For behold, you look for truth deep within me, and will make me understand. that the body you have broken may rejoice.
I do praise for my sin and blot out all my iniquity.
Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me.
Cast me not away from your presence, and take me to the Holy Spirit of God.
Give me the joy of your saving help again, and sustain me with your bountiful spirit.
I will seek you where you are, and sinners shall return to me.
Deliver me from death, O God, and my tongue shall sing of your righteousness, O God of my salvation.
Open my lips, O Lord, and my mouth shall proclaim your praise.
Had you desired it, I would have offered sacrifice, but you take no delight in burnt offerings. The ministry of the gospel endures many challenges and hardships. Now through this ministry, God's reconciling activity in the death of Christ reaches to the depths of our lives to bring us into a right relationship with God. In this way, God accepts us into the reality of divine salvation. It's a reading from the 5th and 6th chapters of Paul's second letter to the Corinthians. We entreat you on behalf of Christ, be reconciled to God. For our sake, he made him to be sin who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. As we work together with him, we urge you not to accept the grace of God in vain. For he says, at an acceptable time I have listened to you, and on the day of salvation I have helped you. See, now is the acceptable time. See, now is the day of salvation. We are putting no obstacle in anyone's way, so that no fault may be found with our ministry. But as servants of God, we have commended ourselves in every way, through great endurance, in afflictions, hardships, calamities, beatings, imprisonments, riots, labors, sleepless nights, hunger, purity, knowledge, patience, kindness, holiness of spirit, genuine love, truthful spirit, the power of God, with the weapons of righteousness for the right hand and for the left, in honor and dishonor, in ill repute and good repute, we are treated as impostors and yet are true, as unknown and yet well known, as dying and see we are alive, as punished and yet not killed, as sorrowful, yet rejoicing, as poor, yet making many rich, as having nothing, and yet possessing everything. Here ends the reading from 2 Corinthians. Please stand for the gospel acclamation. Do not be like the hypocrites. For they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and on the street corners so that they may be seen by others. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But whenever you pray, go to your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And whenever you fast, do not look dismal like the hypocrites, for they disfigure their faces so as to show others that they are fasting. Truly, I tell you, they have received their reward. But when you fast, put oil on your head and wash your face, so that your fasting may be seen not by others, but by your Father who sees in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. Do not store up for yourselves treasures on earth, where moth and rust consume, and where thieves break in and steal. But store up for yourself treasures in heaven, where neither moth nor rust consumes, and where thieves do not break in and steal. Where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. This is the gospel of the Lord. Please be seated. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be found pleasing to you, O Lord, my rock and my redeemer. This past Sunday, if you were listening to my sermon about Lent beginning on Ash Wednesday, and hopefully you hadn't drifted off at that point, you heard me suggest that instead of giving up something, why not give yourself up to the one who was transfigured on the mountaintop, but then who came down to continue to walk with us, to teach us, to guide us, to inspire us, and then to take our sins to the cross and die for us so that we might have eternal life. Good advice. But the thing is, we usually don't like giving up things, especially control in our lives. It's sometimes full speed ahead. Damn the torpedoes. Well, news alert for you. If you haven't guessed already, torpedoes can knock things out of whack so fast, it can hit you. Okay, maybe we don't have to deal with real torpedoes in real life. But how many times have we had to live with the consequences of our actions simply because we didn't think things through, but yet we did not want to owe up and take the blame ourselves? After all, it's somebody else's fault, right? Well, maybe you should hold off answering that until you have taken a long, hard, honest look deep inside yourself. Even if you don't like what you see, but as you do that, recall the words of the prophet Joel that we heard earlier. Return to the Lord your God, for he is gracious and merciful, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love, and relents from punishment. Even after all that, God is that forgiving. He gives us the grace. He shows mercy. And that's echoed by the psalmist completed to God to go even beyond that, to have mercy on me, O God, according to your loving kindness, in your great compassion. Blot out my offenses. Wash me through and through from my wickedness. Cleanse me from my sin. For I know my transgressions. And my sin is ever before me. Against you only have I sinned. Done what is evil in your sight. Christ, that is the key right there. Not only acknowledging the missteps and the reason why we seem to keep wanting to do them all the time, but actually to stop making them and making a change for good, literally. A do-over, a fresh start, maybe better yet, a fresh restart, a clean heart, a right spirit. Jesus in today's gospel reading is basically asking you, what is in your heart right now? Pause a little bit for 5 seconds. What is in your heart? And then he goes up to the chair. For where your treasure is, there your heart will be also. That one verse says it all. So are you willing to give up what's holding you back from giving yourself to the one who was transfigured on that mountaintop, but who came down to continue to walk with us, to teach us, to guide us, to inspire us, and then take all those sins of ours, take them to the cross, and then die for us so that I have eternal life. It's not too late for a clean heart to be created in us, or a right spirit to be renewed in us. The thing is, though, it isn't just for one day, Ash Wednesday, or one season like Lent, but a true renewal each and every day. You think that's impossible? It's not, because nothing is impossible with God. So are you ready to take that leap of faith? Are you willing to try? It's up to you. Whatever you do, don't make the decision alone. Talk it over, one-on-one, a dialogue. In fact, maybe a continual dialogue. So that a clean heart and a right spirit is renewed each and every day. Lord Jesus, amen. Thank you. now let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. Most holy and merciful God, we confess to you and to one another, before the whole company of heaven, that we have sinned by our own faults, by our own most grievous thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart, or mind, or strength. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We have not forgiven others as we have been forgiven. We have shut our ears to your call to serve as Christ served us. We have not been true to the mind of Christ. We have grieved your Holy Spirit. Our past unfaithfulness, the pride, envy, hypocrisy, and apathy that have infected our lives, we confess to you. Our self-indulgent appetites and ways, and our exploitation of other people, we confess to you. Our negligence in prayer and worship, and our failure to share the faith that is in us, we confess to you. Our neglect of human need and suffering, and our indifference to injustice and cruelty, we confess to you. Our false judgments, our uncharitable thoughts towards our neighbors, our prejudice and contempt towards those who differ from us, we confess to you. Our waste and pollution of your creation, and our lack of concern for those who come after us, we confess to you. Restore us, O God, and let your anger depart from us.
Want to come up, and we'll dip the
accomplish in us, O God, the work of your creation.
And we may show forth the glory of the world.
By the cross and passion of your Son, our Savior.
Bring us all to the holy city of the Lord and the resurrection.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us all our sins. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen us in all goodness, and by the power of the Holy Spirit, keep us in eternal life. Relying on the promises of God, we pray boldly for the church, the world, and all in need. I will end each petition with the Lord in your mercy. Please respond with hear our prayer. O God, you call your church to be ministers of reconciliation throughout the world. Inspire your church in its proclamation of the gospel and guide its ministries to build up the body of Christ. Lord, in your mercy. O God, you created the earth and all its inhabitants, and you declared that it was good. Protect mountains and valleys, animals and plants, and direct us to be good stewards of all that you have made. Lord, in your mercy. O God, you desire peace, so direct governments and leaders in work for the well-being of all people. And raise up advocates to speak and serve on behalf of the downtrodden. Lord, in your mercy. O God, you are our hope in the midst of despair, our help in the midst of sorrow, and our consolation in the midst of affliction. Grant comfort to all who suffer in mind, body, or spirit, and support caregivers who attend all who are in need. Lord, in your mercy. O God, you are love, and you call us to love one another. Accompany with your grace those journeying towards baptism, and call us all to repentance as we prepare to celebrate Christ's death and resurrection. Lord, in your mercy. We lift up now in silence all those other hopes, those personal hopes and concerns that God can see written upon our hearts at this moment. Lord, in your mercy. O God, you are our life and our salvation. We give you thanks for your righteousness and for the righteousness of those who died in faith. Inspire us by their example to proclaim your steadfast love. Lord, in your mercy. We entrust ourselves and all our prayers to you, O faithful God, through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. And as the altar is prepared, please stand before the offertory.
Thank you. to me.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, through Christ our Lord. You bid your people to cleanse their hearts and prepare with joy for the Paschal feast. Renew our zeal in life and faith, and bring us to the fullness of grace that belongs to the children of God. So with the church on earth and the host of heaven, praise your name and join in your unending adventure.
Holy.
God, in power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Continue with Eucharistic prayer number 33, you'll find it on page 7. Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth, in mercy for our fallen world, you gave your only Son, that all who believe in him should not perish but have eternal life. We give thanks to you for the salvation you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Send now your Holy Spirit into our hearts, that we may receive our own word with a living faith, as he comes to us in his Holy Supper. Amen. Amen. Lord Jesus. In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, and broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And again after supper, he took the cup and gave thanks, and gave it to all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new cup. This cup, this cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in remembrance of me." For it is through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. And gathered into one by the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, the glory. And now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen. as a sacrifice for sin and a model of godly life. Enable us to receive him always with thanksgiving and to conform our lives to his. We say in Jesus Christ our Lord. And may God, who has called us forth from the dust of the earth, claim us as children of the light,